acknowledgement of security incidents and sort of existing controversy around the company and what's happened. What is your response to that?
Well, I mean, that it is controversial is not surprising to us, right? I think there is this immediate reaction to biometrics and specifically our scanning, and that is to be expected. However, the technology is actually privacy preserving, and we believe it's going to be very, very important in a time in which AI will become increasingly powerful.
You know, in the first 24 hours of the launch, there was very, very, very significant uptake already when you look at the WorldCoin token that had dropped. How has that uptake continued, and have you seen a tapering at all?
It stayed surprisingly constant, honestly. We did not see much change either up or down. It's very early, of course. This is a multi-year long or even multi-decade long project. So I think we're like super, super early in the game here. However, I'm really, really happy how last week went from all parties. So I think it was a great, great start. But we have a lot of ground to cover going forward.
How many people have now signed up for the scanning? How many people have got into the token? And when do you see it coming to the United States, if at all?
I actually do not have the exact numbers as of right now, but it's a little over 2 million. We had a like crazy, crazy spike in demand last week. We had, I think, over 600,000 app downloads in the first couple of days. And we had lines really all over the world, which was very kind of very encouraging and very cool to see, everywhere from Tokyo to Hong Kong to Singapore to even kind of in Europe, Spain, Argentina, Nairobi. So it was a very, very stressful week. We had a lot of kind of demand to react to. And especially early on, our servers actually broke down under that. But yeah, it's as I said, it's early. We have to grow and kind of roll out more devices in the coming months. So it's really just the beginning of a long sprint.
Alex, we refer to WorldCoin as a crypto project, but I'm interested in the retinal scanning component, the underlying technology. Could you explain to our audience where your competence lays? Is it in that retinal scanning technology that you guys have been doing most of your work, or do you get that from a third party?
So first of all, WorldCoin is a protocol. It's a open source and eventually fully decentralized protocol that everyone can use and everyone can integrate with. So it is not a company. I think that's the first important thing to understand. I'm the CEO of Tools for Humanity, which is a kind of one of the main and of course the founding contributor to WorldCoin, but there will be many others as we go forward. But now to your question, actually explaining where the competence lies, how does it fit together with crypto? The original idea of WorldCoin was starting a financial network based on the idea of proof of personhood. Proof of personhood essentially means that you as a user, you can verify online that you are a unique human being without revealing any privacy related data. So you actually, let's stay actually with Twitter or X, you want to verify on X that you're an actual human being, you're not a bot. Which we believe will be increasingly important as we go forward, as AI becomes increasingly powerful, you will be able to just do that with World ID without revealing any personal information about yourself by using what is called zero knowledge proofs. And that is, for example, that's one of the pieces why crypto is important in cryptography. There is something called zero knowledge proofs that lets you prove certain statements without actually revealing the underlying information, which is very, very important. To do that, so as a user to receive your World ID, you have to verify yourself in front of a physical device. It's a 20 centimeter sphere, it's called the orb, and they will be really all over the world in public spaces, in malls, and even kind of wander around cities. It's a decentralized model, so it's not we as a project operate these, but rather you have entrepreneurs and founders all over the world that actually can operate these devices and then earn WorldCoin before you sign up. And you as a user, you download the app, it's called World App, which is the first app that actually allows you to do that, but many others will come. And you click on a map, you say, I want to verify now, you go in front of one of those devices, and you receive your world ID, which then lets you verify online with whoever integrates it in the future.
Sam Altman is one of the founders of this initiative and World ID. Day to day, what role does he play? How are you and he separating your time and your duties?
Sam is very clearly focused on OpenAI, given he's the CEO of OpenAI and I'm the CEO of Tools for Humanity. However, he is a co-founder here. So all important initiatives, he's obviously very aware of. If there's work streams that really touch him, he's involved with. And otherwise, his involvement changes week to week, depending on what we actually work on. Like, is it mostly product or engineer focused? He's less involved. If it's, let's say, a fundraise, he's much more involved. That really depends on what is happening in the business day to day.
Now, I'm kind of curious here. We talked about the Kenyan government's reaction to WorldCoin more recently at the start of this interview. I'm wondering if you are working with the Kenyan government to address some of the concerns that they may have, given how important the market was earlier on in the project.
Yes, we work with the government, with actually multiple government bodies to resolve all the open uncertainties or questions that there are. Certainly, the kind of the spike in demand that we saw last week was very, very surprising. So we really hope that we can get back to delivering the actual product in Kenya. However, of course, we will comply with the government and all the questions that might arise and work with all the regulators that are important to do so. So we stopped operating in Kenya until that is the fact, and we hope that we can resume operations.
Now, how do you address security concerns as well, recognizing that there were worries about stolen credentials when it came to World ID earlier on, black market sales? Are these things that you are working and find a way to prevent in the future?
Yes, they actually are not surprising. So essentially, first of all, let's explain what we're actually talking about here and what was reported on. What was reported on is that users in countries where, let's say, WorldCoin is not available, China, buy accounts from users where WorldCoin is available, let's say Portugal or Nairobi. And what that actually means is not you do not sell your biometric data or anything like that. I think that was one of the major misunderstandings that is very important to clarify, but rather you sell your login credentials. So let's say your email address and your password, let's say. That's the best analogy to kind of normal use cases. And that is not even in midterm, it's not a concern because as a user, you can just recover your account. You can go back to an orb and recover your account. And essentially what that means is that the other party that acquired the account basically acquired something that will turn out to be worthless because the login credentials will just stop working. And so this is not an actual medium to long-term concern. And privacy from the user is not compromised in any form.